Dear students, this is Dr. Shilpa Kapoor and the topic of my video is Michelson interferometer. Contains introduction, construction, working, what does this pattern tell us, applications and uses. Introduction. What is interference? It is the phenomena which is associated with the wave nature of light. The phenomena of modification of intensity of light obtained by the superposition of two or more beams of light is called as interference. If the resultant intensity is zero or less than we expect from the separate intensities, we have destructive interference, while if it is greater, we have constructive interference. Michelson interferometer. The figure 1 shows the Michelson interferometer. A Michelson interferometer is a tool to produce interference between two beams of light. The Michelson interferometer produces interference fringes by splitting a beam of monochromatic light such that one beam hits a fixed mirror and the other hits a movable mirror. When the reflected beams are combined, an interference pattern is formed. This is known as interference by amplitude. To create interference fringes on a detector, the path have to be of different length or composed of different materials. Michelson interferometers are relatively simple in operation. They also possess a relatively low temperature sensitivity. Construction. Figure 2 shows the construction of Michelson interferometer. The main optical parts consist of two highly polished mirrors, M1 and M2, and a plain parallel plate of glass G1 and a beam splitter. Sometimes the rear side of the beam splitter is slightly silvered so that the light coming from the source is divided into two parts, first reflected and second transmitted. Both the beams are of equal intensity. The mirror M1 is fixed to a movable carriage and can be moved along the well-machined ways or tracks. This slow and accurately controlled motion is accomplished by means of the screw. To obtain the interference fringes, the mirror M1 and M2 are made exactly perpendicular to each other. Even when this adjustment has been made, the fringes will not be seen unless the two important requirements are fulfilled. First, the light must originate from an extended source, and second, the light must be in general monochromatic or nearly so. Working. We can understand the working from the figure 3. So, from the figure 3, we can see that the light from a source strikes a partially silvered beam splitter, causing a beam to be reflected towards the mirror M1 fixed to a movable carriage. The remainder of the beam is transmitted from the beam splitter towards a fixed mirror M2. A glass compensation plate along the path toward M2 ensures that the two paths are effectively identical. The two beams, once reflected from the mirror M1 and M2, reconverge at the beam splitter. When recombined and aligned, the beam falls on the interferometer's viewing screen, where the resultant light exhibits interference effects dependent on the length difference between the two paths. It can be noted that from the figure that reflected ray passes through the beam twice, whereas the transmitted ray does not so even once. Thus, in the absence of another glass plate, G1, the two paths are not equal. To equalize the path, The glass plate is introduced between the beam splitter and the fixed mirror M2, which is known as compensating plate. The thickness and the material of the compensating plate is same as that of the beam splitter. If the distance from the beam splitter to the mirrors M1 and M2 differ by the distance d, then the total difference in the path length traveled by the two beam of light is 2d. When the distance 2d is equal to an integer multiple of the light wavelength, constructive interference is observed at the viewing screen as shown in the figure. The crest of the two beam overlap and a bright spot or the ring is seen in the viewing screen. Mathematically, this condition is described by the equation 2d, where lambda is the wavelength of the light and small m is an integer. Patterns of the fringes. What does this pattern tell us? The change in the path difference is twice the distance d. The mirror moves because the light must travel to a movable mirror then back to the splitter. In order for an intensity maximum at detector constructive interference, the condition m lambda is equals to 2d, where m is an integer. A path difference of 0 will result in the constructive interference, while a total path difference of a half wavelength will produce destructive interference. The alternating light and dark fringes produced applications and uses. The key applications of Michelson interferometer are as follows. It is used in the Michelson Morley experiment, which has led to the development of the special theory of the relativity. In astronomical interferometry, in optical coherence tomography, in the determination of wavelength of monochromatic source of light, in the determination of refractive index and thickness of various thin transparent materials, for the detection of gravitational waves as a tunable narrow band fitter, and last as a core of the Fourier transform spectroscopy.